Hi, let's talk about the right ventricle. In this video, we'll discuss the structures unique to the right ventricle. So the right ventricle receives blood from the right atrium. We can see the orifice for the tricuspid valve there. Recall that there are anterior, posterior, and septal cusps for the tricuspid valve. As there are three cusps, there's going to be sets of chordae tendini, tendinous cords which attach to those cusps and connect them to extensions of the myocardium called papillary muscles. Now there are anterior, posterior, and septal papillary muscles, but there is no fidelity between the chordae tendini from any particular cusp to these papillary muscles. So for instance, anterior and posterior cusps will have chordae tendini that attach to both anterior and posterior papillary muscles. The anterior papillary muscle is the largest among the papillary muscles, and it's the most anteriorly oriented. We can see that there, as well as chordae tendini from a cusp of the tricuspid valve there. In association with that is going to be a large extension of myocardium that cuts across, and we can see that here, it's been cut, the right ventricle called the septomarginal trabecula. Septomarginal trabecula is also known as the moderator band. It was first described by Leonardo da Vinci, and it was thought that it moderated the expansion of the right ventricle. We now know that it's a shortcut for the lion's share of the right bundle branch as it cuts across to serve the wall of the right ventricle. The walls of the ventricles are very rough with ridges of muscle. These are invaginations of the myocardium surrounded by the endocardium called trabecula carni, or meaty beams. And we'll see this, we'll have a better opportunity to see it in the left ventricle. We don't have a good view of it here in the right ventricle. There's also an interventricular septum. It has muscular parts and membranous parts to it. And then finally, as blood leaves the right ventricle, we can see that here. It's heading towards the pulmonary valve and the pulmonary trunk, but the region here is called the conus arteriosus, and it is very smooth walled. So there isn't a whole lot of contraction that's occurring there. We don't want a whole lot of turbulence going through the valves, and so that conus arteriosus is very smooth. In terms of the valves associated with the right ventricle, we know there's the tricuspid valve with its anterior, posterior, and septal cusp. That's regulating blood in. And then there's the pulmonary valve, which regulates blood out of the right ventricle. So during systole, the atrioventricular valve, the tricuspid valve is closed, and the semilunar valve is open. During diastole, it's the opposite. The tricuspid valve is open, and the pulmonary valve is closed. The chordae tendini attaching to papillary muscles are going to prevent the cusps of the tricuspid valve from moving back into the atria. So they hold them in place. They don't actually close the cusp. Interventricular pressure buildup does that, but they do hold them in place and prevent the backwards regurgitation of the valves and blood with the valves. So we've discussed the structures that are peculiar to the right ventricle. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.